안녕하세요. 안차키입니다. We welcome you to another edition of Let's Speak Korean. And here with us, as usual, is 지승현 선생님. 안녕하세요, 선생님.
안녕하세요. 안녕하세요, 지승현입니다. 다시 만나서 반가워요. It will be another useful lesson for you, so don't go away.
In our last lesson, we learned how to convert sentences with nouns into reported speech. Let's get a quick review now. 선생님이 좋아하는 음식이 뭐라고 했죠?
냉면이라고 했죠. 안차기 씨가 좋아하는 음식도 냉면이라고 했죠?
You remembered. Mm-hmm. Right. Now, 냉면, if you recall, is a cold noodle dish that is enjoyed by Koreans, especially during the hot summer months. Isn't that right?
Right. Nothing like it to beat the heat,
Absolutely.
Right?
Well, in this lesson, we'll find out how to turn requests into the reported speech. All right, let's go and watch the clip now.
민욱 씨, 내일 뭐 할 거예요?
친구들이 야구장에 가자고 하는데요.
그래요? 전 아직 야구장에 한 번도 안 가봤는데 야구 구경하는 거 재미있어요?
그럼요. 아주 신나요. 마이클 씨도 시간 있으면 같이 가요.
그럼 이번 기회에 저도 한번 가볼까요?
그래요. 같이 가요.
내일 몇 시에 어디에서 만나는데요?
4시에 매표소 앞에서 만나자고 했어요.
Michael asks Minook what he plans to do tomorrow, and Minook answers that his friends asked him to go watch a baseball game. Michael says that he has never been to a baseball game, and Minook asks him to come along if he has the time. Michael asks where and at what time they should meet, and Minook says he will be meeting his friends at 4 o'clock in front of the ticket booth. All right, then, let's get a check of the key expression in this lesson. We'll learn how to turn statements of request into the reported speech. It's the verb stem plus 자고 하다. Let's start off by learning some simple phrases that we will need to learn the full expressions. Please listen carefully to 선생님.
농구 경기를 보다. 농구 경기를 보다. 조카를 데리고 오다. 조카를 데리고 오다. 집까지 걸어가다. 집까지 걸어가다. 창문을 닫다. 창문을 닫다.
I trust you've been following along. All right then, let's take a look at the clip once again to see how the phrase 자고 하다 is used.
친구들이 야구장에 가자고 하는데요. 4시에 매표소 앞에서 만나자고 했어요.
Michael asks Minook what he plans to do tomorrow, and Minook answers that his friends have asked him to go watch a baseball game. How did he say this in Korean?
친구들이 야구장에 가자고 하는데요.
Michael then asks at what time and where they plan to meet, and Minook says that they're going to meet at 4 o'clock in front of the ticket booth. How did he say this?
4시에 매표소 앞에서 만나자고 했어요.
So this is what we'll be learning in this lesson. That is, we're going to learn how to turn requests into the reported speech form. Now, 선생님, mm-hmm. could you tell us more about this?
Sure. Well, we have learned how to end a request with either 읍시다, 비읍시다, or 요, right? But when we turn them into reported speech, we have to attach the expression 자고 하다 to the verb stem. So for statements requesting something, we have to add the expression 자고 하다 to the verb stem to turn it into reported speech. 농구 경기를 봅시다 becomes 농구 경기를 보자고 하다. The sentence 조카를 데리고 옵시다 becomes 조카를 데리고 오자고 하다. 집까지 걸어가요. This sentence becomes 집까지 걸어가자고 하다. And 창문을 닫아요 becomes 창문을 닫자고 하다.
Now, requests are usually in the present tense, but you can change the 하다 part in 자고 하다 into the past and future tenses with 해요, 했어요, and 할 거예요.
걸어가자고 해요. 걸어가자고 했어요. 걸어가자고 할 거예요.
Now that that is clear, let's practice some complete sentences along with 선생님.
동생이 농구 경기를 보자고 하는데요. 다음에는 조카를 데리고 오자고 할 거예요. 친구가 집까지 걸어가자고 했어요. 바람이 불어서 창문을 닫자고 했어요.
It's time for some extra expressions. What did Minook say when Michael asked him what he plans to do tomorrow? Well, he actually said that he plans to meet his friends to go watch a baseball game. How did he say this?
친구들이 야구장에 가자고 하는데요. 친구들이 야구장에 가자고 하는데요.
The word 야구장 means baseball stadium. Now, Michael also asked Minook if it's fun to watch a baseball game. What was Minook's answer to this?
아주 신나요. 아주 신나요.
신나요 is the adjective form of the infinitive 신나다. All right, this means exciting. 신나다 means exciting. Now, there were some other new words that we ran across in this lesson. What did Michael say when Minook asked him to come along if he has the time?
이번 기회에 저도 한번 가볼까요? 이번 기회에 저도 한번 가볼까요?
This means that maybe I should take the opportunity to come along this time. Now, the word 기회 here means opportunity. Now, what is the first place that we would drop by when we visit a baseball stadium? Well, it has to be the ticket booth, right?
4시에 매표소 앞에서 만나자고 했어요. 4시에 매표소 앞에서 만나자고 했어요.
In this sentence, Minook is saying that he has an appointment to meet with his friends at 4 o'clock in front of the ticket booth. Now, the word 매표소 here is, of course, the ticket booth. All right, then, it is time to get a wrap-up of what we have learned in this lesson. So let's go over the expressions one by one along with the clip.
민욱 씨, 내일 뭐 할 거예요?
민욱 씨, 내일 뭐 할 거예요?
친구들이 야구장에 가자고 하는데요.
친구들이 야구장에 가자고 하는데요.
마이크 씨도 시간 있으면 같이 가요.
마이크 씨도 시간 있으면 같이 가요.
그럼 이번 기회에 저도 한번 가볼까요?
그럼 이번 기회에 저도 한번 가볼까요?
내일 몇 시에 어디에서 만나는데요?
내일 몇 시에 어디에서 만나는데요?
4시에 매표소 앞에서 만나자고 했어요.
4시에 매표소 앞에서 만나자고 했어요.
'Here now is the entire clip once again from the beginning, so this is your opportunity to memorize the expressions.
민욱 씨, 내일 뭐 할 거예요?
친구들이 야구장에 가자고 하는데요.
그래요? 전 아직 야구장에 한 번도 안 가봤는데 야구 구경하는 거 재미있어요?
그럼요. 아주 신나요. 마이클 씨도 시간 있으면 같이 가요.
그럼 이번 기회에 저도 한번 가볼까요?
그래요. 같이 가요.
내일 몇 시에 어디에서 만나는데요?
4시에 매표소 앞에서 만나자고 했어요.
We've reached the part of our lesson where we learn some accurate Korean pronunciations. We'll take a closer look at the 받침, 이응 this time. Let's listen to 선생님's explanation.
When the 받침 sound 이응 is followed by a consonant or a vowel sound, all we have to do is just read as it is. For instance, the word 강에 is a combination of the word 강 for river and the particle 에. It is pronounced as 강에. As for the word 장소, the letter 장 is followed by the letter 소, and it is also read as 장소, just as it is written.
All right, now let's go over this pronunciation rule one more time by going over some complete sentences. Please follow along with 선생님.
방에 갑시다. 방에서 쉬세요. 만나는 장소가 어디예요? 병문안 갈까요? 시장과 서점에 갔어요.
We have reached the end of this edition of Let's Speak Korean. In this lesson, we learn how to turn requests into the reporter's speech form when we want to tell a person what someone has requested. Let's go for a quick review now. 선생님, mm-hmm. 내일 뭐 할 거예요?
친구들이 영화 보러 가자고 했어요. 안찾기 씨는 내일 뭐 할 거예요?
가족들이 등산하자고 했어요.
That sounds good. Mm-hmm.
Well, we've run out of time for now. So until next time, keep practicing your Korean and we'll see you then. 안녕히 계세요.